The crowd is ready. Tonight, the top 13 go head-to-head on this stage to win your votes. Welcome to the party. This is American Idol.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your judges, Randy Jackson, Steven Tyler, Jennifer Lopez. Please welcome your host, Ryan Seacrest.
As our top 13 debut. The official countdown to the finale begins right here tonight. But have you guys picked your favorite yet? Let's hear it. Who's your favorite? Shout it out. Name a name. Okay, all right. We shall see. Keep the energy up for our judges. Special congratulations to Jennifer Lopez, her single number one on iTunes. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you, guys. Thank you.
Right now, let's unleash the talented individuals who are fighting it out for your votes. America, here's your top 13. Let's go. Set. We'll see you in a little bit. Okay, gang, good luck to you this evening. Have fun. We'll see you in just a second here. So this week, we've asked the contestants to choose a song by their personal idol. And to raise the stakes, everyone had their first official opportunity to work with the chairman of Interscope, Jimmy Iovine, along with his team of Grammy Award-winning record producers. Everyone's worked round the clock, honestly, to perfect these songs for you that the contestants are going to sing on this stage right now. Jimmy is here, I think, to keep an eye on them. Oh, I'd be worried. Good to see you, buddy. Kicking us off tonight is Georgia's own Lauren. Roll the tape. Let's go.
My idol is Shania Twain because she's like a country music legend. She was the first female artist to kind of mix country and pop music together as one musical style. I chose Any Man of Mine because it's a really fun song and it can show off my personality, and it's just, I'm gonna have a great time on stage with it.
There she is.
I'm working with the producer Don West, and I really feel comfortable with him because he cares about how I feel about the song.
Sing something that comes from you, make it your own.
Jimmy just kind of showed it. I was like, oh God. It's a little intimidating working with the producers, but I try to keep my focus because if I lose my focus, I'm gonna totally screw up. Shania Twain is a country music diva, and hopefully one day I will be too.
The music business is about selling emotion. We've got something great here. This girl's gonna have a big career.
Lauren's really got it all, man. I think she's a real star.
I say another woman's looking better than me. And when I cook dinner and I burn it black, you better say, I like it like that, yeah. And if I change my mind a million times, I wanna hear him say, yeah. Show me a squeeze and squeeze and please it count as high. I need a man who knows how the story goes. He's gotta be a heartbeating, fine, treating, breathtaking, earthquaking kind. Any man on fire, let me hear you say yeah, yeah, yeah. I like it that way.
Any man.
Show me a tease and squeeze and please it kind of time. I need a man who knows how the story goes. He's got a real heartbeat, fire dream, breathtaking, earthquake and kind. Any man of mine. Thank you.
Hey, well, you know how much I love your voice. I don't think anybody'd be up here if it wasn't for the fact of a good song. Gotta have a good song. I love that song, but I wished it just been a little bit more kick-ass. And you know how much I love your voice, girl.
Right? Well, you know, the thing with me, Lauren, is that you always sound so amazing. And like I said last week, you know, it doesn't even seem like you have to. You don't have to try. You're that good. But I think what we want to feel from you now is you really, really just like kick it into high gear. Mm. Like really, really go there. You have an amazing voice. You're super comfortable up there. Now it's time. I mean, this is it. The competition starts today. We love you.
Yo, and just to echo what the guys are saying here, I mean, you know, what we want for you, I mean, that's a cool song. I mean, I love Shania. We had her as a guest on the show many times, her great collaborator, Mutt Lange, brilliant. And you sang it well, but I guess what we're hoping for is that girl that we first saw, we want America to see more of that, that you can sing this, you can sing anything. Your voice is so big, I don't think you even know how talented you are. So I guess that's what we really want, something that lets you just shine beyond belief. Not sure this song did quite that, but it was good.
Yeah.
Great.
All right, Lauren. How'd you feel about it?
I mean, I had a good time.
It was great, baby.
Do you understand what they're saying?
Yeah. I mean, I just didn't want to do a ballad because that's what everybody does, and I just wanted to, like, kick it up, but obviously I didn't, Steve, and I'm sorry.
Oh, no, baby, I love the way you sing.
No.
Constructive criticism, right?
Constructive.
If you want to vote for Lauren, 1-866-IDOL-01. It's 1-866-436-5701. If you're with AT&T, you can text them to vote to 5701 from your wireless phone. They're 866 numbers, not 800 numbers, so please dial carefully, or you can go online and vote at AmericanIdol.com. Lauren, thank you very much. Good
Thanks,
luck, sweetheart.
Teachers.
You're welcome, darling.
Oh, I'm gonna get you for that. After this, some Joe Cocker and Diana Ross coming to you from Casey and Ashton. We'll be right back.
I feel like everything's up to America at this point, so they liked it or they didn't. I don't know.
Our camera backstage. Welcome back to American Idol. Tonight, our top 13 are taken on songs by their idols. Let's find out who inspires Casey. Watch.
One of my idols is Joe Cocker, and I'm doing With a Little Help from My Friends. First time I heard this song, I was like 5, and I just remembered I heard it on the Wonder Years, so that it really stuck in my head.
The opening of the song, what would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Look right at those judges.
All right.
Okay.
Hopefully I can get a smile out of that, yeah.
Well, you get a reaction.
Joe Cocker's got that growl in his voice, and then he doesn't look that hot either, and I think he's inspired that look for me.
This song is physical. Just let the audience see it and feel it.
Okay.
If you watched Joe Cocker sing this song, there wasn't one inch of his body that wasn't just feeling it.
Just spasming. Right.
Yeah. You can't sing like that and be casual.
Okay. When Joe Cocker sings, he can feel the music throughout his whole body, and he sweats the music, and you don't hear him, you feel him. And that's what I want. I want to be felt.
What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. And I try not to sing out of key. Oh, baby, now I have a little help from my friends. I'm gonna get high, a little help from my friends. I'll get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, woo! Woo, 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 yeah! Do you need anybody? Oh, I just want someone to love.
Feel, you know, notes, pitch, whatever, it doesn't even matter. By the way, I'm not saying anything about your notes or pitch, it's amazing. But I'm just saying in general, we go by what we feel. And you just, honestly, there was one point I just grabbed Randy and I was like, what am I watching right now?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm watching somebody important. Like, wow, wow. Blew me away. Blew me away.
Well, yo, listen, what Jen was watching is Idol Season 10, the remix!
Right.
Listen, man, listen. Every time you come up to sing, I'm always excited to see what you're gonna do, how you're gonna do it. You know, last week you did a thing that kind of had a little of an angry tone, but you explained it today, saying that you love Joe Cocker, right? So you come up with all this stuff, but dude, you were so unbelievable and so exciting. You hit all the notes always. You make listening to you sing fun, and I
Amazing.
Loved it. I loved it, dude, I loved it.
Yeah, Casey, I think what Randy was trying to say was, you are a rainbow of talent, man.
Yeah.
You never exactly. cease to amaze me every time you get up there with what you do. Thanks. And you are a plethora of passion. Everybody in the house felt everything you did. You came to do what you wanted to do,
That's
you did it,
That's a big old word, Stephen, plethora. I like that.
And I didn't spit anything in.
Good job, man.
Thank you so much.
Nice. What were you channeling when you were singing? I mean, we could see friends. You were channeling something.
I was just so happy, you know. I think Joe Cocker embodied me for a second. Not that I'm Joe Cocker, I'm just saying that he inspired me for the passion.
There you go.
You know?
Yeah, exactly. He's in there. All right. Don't forget, Jennifer, American Idol. That's what you're watching, 8, 7 Central on Fox. All right, Casey's number is 1-866-IDOL-02. 1-866-436-5702. Or you can text or vote, 5702. You have at least 2 hours to vote, but not until the end of the show. Casey, thank you very much, buddy. Always good to see you, man.
Thank you.
Now let's move on to the girl who narrowly escaped elimination last week by getting a wild card spot. Here's Ashton.
I don't know. I just feel something different for you, but
you're
I like
Ross.
You.
You're Diana
yeah, you're Ross, Diana
please.
Ross, baby. Ross.
That's a big compliment.
Diana Ross has had a big career, and I'm singing one of her songs called When You Tell Me That You Love Me. I can't wait to do it. It's such a beautiful song.
I'll make you safe no matter where you are.
Stop it right there. That's good.
Can't believe that I'm working with Roddy Jerkins. He's worked with Mariah Carey, to Keisha, to Monica. It's just amazing.
Stronger!
Woo!
Are you sure?
Yes.
I've never went that high in a song before.
You gotta open it up,
yes.
Open it up.
It's my first time singing this high.
But you're doing it. That means it can be done. So we gonna push you, here we go.
I'm just glad that they're taking me to a place that I've never been.
I was slightly nervous about the range of her voice, about being able to take the top end note. Her and Rodney worked on it and did a really great job. I was so inspired that I wanted to invite Berry Gordy from Motown to watch us sing that song tonight because it was just beautiful.
I wanna call the stars down from the sky. I wanna live a day that never dies. I wanna change the world only for you. All the impossible I wanna do. And baby, every time you touch me, I become a hero. I'll make you safe no matter where you are, and bring you everything you ask for. Nothing is above me. I'm shining like a candle in the dark. When you tell me that you love me,
hey,
in a world without you, I will always hunger. All I need is your love to make tell me that you love me, love me, oh yeah. When you tell me that you love me.
Yo, listen, I tell you what, I liked it. Berry is here, the great Berry Gordy, one of the greatest ever, ever, ever in the music industry, ever. And listen, I tell you what, I was a little worried seeing the song that you were doing because I was like, well, you know, I don't know how this is gonna go or whatever, but I gotta tell you what, it sounded like it was a little bit of a safe move, but you know what? I actually liked it because I saw you grow a little bit more as a singer as you paid attention to the notes when you were going a little sharper flat. You pulled it back in with the vibrato, so I think you actually did yourself some good with that. I liked it.
And I agree with Randy. I think there's a lot more in there than you're showing us and that you're going to. So I got confidence in you.
You're just, you know, you're so elegant up there. And we are seeing what a real professional you are, you know, already. You know, he's right. You know, there was moments where it was kind of like getting away from you and you pulled it back in and you kept your composure and you did it. Now I want to start seeing you sing songs that we can kind of sing along with you. I think the past couple of weeks you've done songs that maybe people don't know as well. You know, some Diana Ross songs, you know, everybody knows. I would have maybe liked to see that, but still, I love you and I think that you're amazing. You're awesome.
Thank you.
Let's hear it for Ashton. Hey, last week when we saw your face and you were like, it's me, and ran across this stage was a moment. How has that changed the way you sing when you're up here?
Well, you know, I don't know. I don't want people to look at me as just an edge all the time. I want people to see the soft side of me, you know, the elegant side, who Ashton Jones really is.
And you're back with that second chance. If you want to vote for Ashton, 1-866-IDOL-03. It's 1-866-436-5703, or you can text the word vote to 5703. Also, vote online at AmericanIdol.com. Good luck, darling. Thank you very much. We're going to take a quick break now, but when we come back, all fans will get their fix. Hang tight.
That's what I'm talking about. It could have been bad, it could have been good, but the three judges loved it, so I'm happy. I'm so excited. I'm excited.
Back with you on American Idol as our top 13 take the stage with songs from their idols. Ever wondered who Paul looks up to? Let's find out.
My idol is Ryan Adams with an R. He's a brilliant songwriter, and lyrically, I just like what he does. And this is also the kind of artist that I look up to and admire and kind of want to be more like. I am singing Ryan Adams' Come Pick Me Up.
Okay, man. How are you doing? How are you?
Rehearsals have been going extremely well. I've been working with Don Was, the legendary big baller in the music scene. We kind of clicked immediately.
That was a very nice jacket you were wearing.
It was cool working with him and kind of vibing off of him.
Yeah, it's awesome, man.
Cool.
The only thing is, I think you got to resolve the last thing.
I wish you would.
You just got to nail this chorus. This chorus comes on, you just got to just.
Yeah.
It's about your intensity.
Working with Jimmy has been an amazing experience as well. You know, he is one of the biggest dudes in the business.
Paul is a voice that idols needed for a long time. He's got an understated, powerful rasp. He sings out. He shows everyone what that voice sounds like. He's gonna do great.
Y'all doing all right this evening, y'all?
When they call your name, will you walk right up with a smile on your face? Will you cower in fear in your favorite sweater? With an old love letter. Oh, I wish you would. I wish you would. Come pick me up. Take me out. Mess me up. Steal my records. I lose all my friends. I go full of hell. I wear the smile on your face and then do it all again. Come on, come pick me up. Come on, baby. Take me out. Mess me up and steal all my records. I lose all my friends. I go full of hell. With a smile on your face and then do it all again. Oh, I wish you would.
Yeah, baby.
Paul, I love the character and the rasp in your voice. I love it so much it doesn't matter whose song you do. It winds up being yours. A little pitchy. Be careful next time. And watch out. Find a song where a chorus is your key. Cool. Nail it next time. But I love your voice, man.
Right on. Thank you so much, man.
You know, I just love, as you were singing, I was just looking around at some of the audience members and seeing them watch you move. And they're just smiling. They're just like, wow, look at him. You're just so unique. There's just something about you. And you did move the crowd. I hope America gets it. I don't know. I don't know Ryan Adams or that song, you know. And I know a lot of music, so.
You will. You should. You know,
I should. I'm going to look it up. But I hope they get it, because I do cool. really think that you're great.
Well, thank you so much. Thank you.
Yo, listen, let me just say this. After last week's performance, you doing Rod Stewart and all of that, I'm sure it wasn't probably the most exciting thing for people, but I think what I love about you is I love the character who you are. I love who Paul is, and I love Ryan Adams, right? I thought maybe you'd pick the song too or something like that, but I know what this guy loves. He loves Whiskey Town. He loves Wilco. You love that kind of a thing, and it was great you were in the studio with Don Was because he comes from that too. With the kind of awesome. Traveling Wilburys, with all that kind of a thing. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I get it, and I hope America gets it. I'm a huge fan, and you're different, and I love you for this show.
Thank you so much.
Paul McDonald, what exactly are the steps to the Paul McDonald? What are the steps if people want to do that at home?
You have to practice really hard to do it, you know? It's something like,
It's just like, If you want to vote for Paul, the numbers. 1-866-IDOL-04. It's 1-866-436-5704. Or you can text the word vote to 5704. Please don't vote until the end of the show. Thank you, Paul.
Thank you, Bill.
I got to stretch before I do this stuff. When we come back, can Pia top her stellar performance from last week? Be right back.
Thanks, man. Good job.
I hope America gets what I did today. You know, it's one of my favorite tunes, one of my favorite artists. So if you like me, you'll like the song. So hopefully you guys get it. I love y'all, for real.
Thank you for making the number one show on television a part of your night. Say hi to Pia, ladies and gentlemen. Take us, Pia, behind the scenes for a second before you sing. We saw you guys Thursday night after the results. What happens between when you go off the air and the cameras stop rolling until now? You're dressed and ready to go.
Well, after the wild card show, we went straight to our top 13 party, and we did tons of press. We had so many interviews. The next day was a photo shoot. We've had premieres. We've had studio sessions. It's been great. And then on top of that, it's rehearsal.
And you all live in a mansion together.
We all live in a mansion together.
How's life in those close quarters?
It's great. We all get along wonderfully. We're just like a big, happy family.
Yeah, not so close. It's a pretty big house.
It's very big.
Good luck to you this evening, all right?
Thank you.
Let's see who Pia has admired. Watch this.
Ever since I was 8 years old, I've loved Celine Dion. She's very family-oriented, and I am as well. And I feel like, you know, having the career that she does and being able to stay so close with your family is extremely important. Tonight, I chose All By Myself. It's a very emotional song. I can really connect with it. And, you know, my dad has always instilled in me to rehearse, rehearse, rehearse.
When I was young.
Shorter. When I was young.
Okay. Sing the reverb. I want the tone to escape the word.
Okay.
Try it again.
Having Interscope working with us this year is amazing. Jimmy Iovine and Ron Fair are two people that I've always wanted to meet and work with.
Chorus.
Was always a challenge for me, and now I could finally sing it because I've rehearsed so much, and I'm really hoping to make my dad proud tonight.
You sang it impeccably. You sounded exactly the way you sounded it recording in the studio. It sounds great. You look really comfortable. Just do that, and we're home.
Thank you.
When I was young, I never needed anyone. Making love was just for fun. Those days are gone. Living alone, I think of all the friends I know. And when I dial the telephone, nobody's home. Oh, don't wanna be all by myself.
He said it. We love you, Pia. I mean... I think a lot of people were thinking what you were gonna do to top last week. There it is. There it is. Really, really beautiful.
Thank you.
Really beautiful.
Thank you so much.
Yo, I mean, it's been a lot of years on this show. This is season 10 for me. And it's funny because we always tell people the big three are the Mariah, Whitney, Celine's, right? Those girls alive probably sold more records than probably any females in the world. And we always say, don't tackle those songs if you can't do them. What I love about you, you did it last week as well. You did it on a Pretender song, but this was even tougher because you know Celine can slay these songs, but you have that quality. That's what I like about you. You, these notes that you hit, you just hit them dead on, like without even thinking about it. You have such a natural gift that, dude, I love it. I'm in awe every time, and I'm always excited when you're coming up to sing. I'm like, yo, what's she gonna do now? Very hot, dope, cool performance.
Thank you.
Pia, yeah, that was the sum total of all the work you've done up till now. You polished that apple. Happy International Women's Day today, by the way. You made a lot of them happy and a lot of
Steven.
Men.
Thank you.
You just slammed it. That was beautiful.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Good job, darling. You got from Randy, you got a dude, yo, what's she gonna do, and a dope all in one critique. If you wanna vote for Pia, the numbers are 1-866-IDOL-05, 1-866-436-5705. Smile at your dad there watching in New York, or you can text the word vote to 5705. Weigh in online too, AmericanIdol.com, but don't do anything until the end of the show. Thank you very much. Next up, some rock and country courtesy of James and Haley.
You've always wanted me to perform a Celine song, and this is my chance on American Idol. I love you so much.
Welcome back to our Top 13 extravaganza. Let's see who James Durbin looks up to. Watch this. Roll it.
Paul McCartney from the Beatles is my idol. He's so versatile, you know, he's one of the greatest musicians, the greatest writers, and the greatest singers that there's ever been and there ever will be. And I hope that I can get that way as well. The song I'm gonna be singing is Maybe I'm Amazed. When I got to meet with my producer, Jim Johnson at Interscope, he had this whole new idea for the song that would bring not just Paul's vision for it, but also his and my vision as well.
The great thing about American Idol this year, there's so many diverse voices you can hear. A voice like James can finally get heard right now, which is very difficult in the record business. You don't hear that many voices like that. I didn't even know kids were out there singing like that.
Maybe I'm amazed at the way you love me all the time. Maybe I'm afraid of the way I love you. Maybe I'm amazed at the way you pulled me out of time and hung me on the line. Maybe I'm amazed at the way I really need you. Maybe I'm a man, maybe I'm a lonely man who's in the middle of something that he doesn't really understand. Maybe baby, won't you help me to understand? Maybe I'm afraid of the way I love you.
Yo. James. So listen, man, listen, you're one of my favorites in this whole thing, and I'm gonna tell you why. Like, back in the day, you know, when I was, like, growing up, before, like, I was able to join the Journey Boys and love rock music and all this kind of stuff that I was able to do, I love these kind of voices that could sing anything. So let me get it straight. Last week, you sing Judas Priest. You, like, rocked the house, first time ever on the show. Now you come out and sing Paul McCartney and slay it?
Yes, sir.
Dude, no. You just kind of turn the other cheek. Showed that you had a sensitive side with the falsetto thing going up. I was like, yo, this dude can do anything, man. Dude, James Durbin is dangerous, America. This man can sing.
James, you have taken everything you ever felt and kicked it into the middle of next week. If there was ever a review to be said about you, you just sang it.
Thank you.
And you did such a good job, man. Thank you.
So good.
Let them clap, baby, when they want to clap. Let them clap.
Feel it.
And seriously get used to it, because you have such a quality, because everybody knows you for those notes, those high notes, those high A's you sang last week, just screaming and getting up there. But the truth is, you have what the greatest rock singers have, and that's a melodic quality to your voice. You can really actually sing. You have vibrato at the end. It's just everything. You're everything. Really, really great.
Nice. Now let him cheer, right? Good job, Em. James, we do have a 2-hour show. We got to get done soon. You've evolved your look a little bit. How would you change?
No tail.
That's...
I got a haircut today, too.
Haircut and no tail. When it's free, get it cut every week.
Clean shaven.
Nice. Well done for James. 1-866-IDOL-06. 1-866-436-5706. If you are with AT&T, you can text the word vote to 5706 from your wireless phone. You can also vote online this year at AmericanIdol.com. James, thank you very much, my man. Good to see you, buddy. Now let's hear what Haley is bringing to the table tonight.
Tonight I'm going to be singing Blue from Leanne Rimes. I chose this song because it really hits home for me. It takes me back to when I was a lot younger. I started singing it when I was 8, so it has made a really big impact on my life. I am working with Rock Mafia. It's a duo team. I feel really at home with them.
We pushed her out of her comfort zone, and she pushed back into a great vocal.
Mostly when we make a classic record, it's always a step down from the nostalgia of what it was. I think you can actually reinvent it.
Doing something like this song that has meant so much to me over these years, it symbolizes like the start of my career in a way. It's me getting on that big stage for the very first time.
That's a really tough song to take on, but you sing it so convincing, so powerful, you know, just stay focused. But that was incredible. Most people I know couldn't do that.
Thanks.
So congratulations, that was a great job.
That's so nice of you.
Thank you.
Blue.
Haley, that was beautiful. If you listen real close, you can hear the rest of America roaring, the country and western part of America, how great that was. I knew Leanne way back when she recorded this, and it was a song, I think, that that Patsy Cline never recorded.
Right, right.
Off her first record.
Yeah, I heard that.
Yeah, anyway, Leanne did such a great, you did such a good job tonight.
Thank you.
So, so fine. Thank you very much.
Thanks, I appreciate that.
You know, I think America's really getting to know you now, and you honestly, more than anybody else in the competition, do things with your voice that are so diverse. You really do really special things, you know, it's just like, even in the yodeling in this song, or, you know, goes into the blue part and all that, it's just something so unique to you. We talk about Paul being unique, but Haley has the same type of voice, really, really special.
Thank you.
It was a good job tonight, oh, really good job.
Thank you.
What's up,
Randy?
No, listen. Listen, okay, the good parts. The good parts about it is that last week you do Alicia Keys, then you do Leanne Rimes. That's quite a bit of space in between those two. I like that you can do anything. For me, it was a little boring, actually, if I'm being honest. It was a little sleepy and a little boring for me. Like, you're young.
You're young,
you got all this energy. I just, you know that Haley with that strong, gravelly voice, you can do anything. You're showing other sides of you, but it was a little boring for me. I'm sorry.
I was trying to show a softer side.
I know.
Jennifer, what were you going to say?
I was going to say, you know, that everybody is different, and Haley has a very sexy quality about her when she's up there. She sings in a very sensual way, and she brings that every time she's up there. You know, everybody doesn't have to run all over the stage and doesn't always have to be that, you
it's
know?
It's not so much that. It was just a little sleepy for me. I felt like, I'm at a luau. That's not what you want.
Okay.
You know, Jennifer, the provocative stuff makes Randy uncomfortable, so that's probably, he was feeling a little uncomfortable.
Exactly right.
He starts in jail, I should leave right now.
Yeah. He's feeling the heat. If you're feeling her heat at home and you want to vote for Haley, 1-866-IDOL-07. It's 1-866-436-5707. You can text her or vote to 5707. Also, be sure to log on to AmericanIdol.com to vote online. Calls are toll-free from landlines and standard text rates apply. Thank you very much, Haley. Good luck.
Thank you.
On the other side, Lusk takes on R. Kelly. Don't miss it. We'll be right back.